The hearing of the case in which city businessman Francis Onebe is accused of killing his wife resumed today before the head of the criminal division of the High Court, Justice Michael Elubu.
We were open and we made the search in the office. The office was not having many items, but our attention was attracted to the diary book.
The fifth prosecution witness, Detective Constable Jacob Okello, who acted as the investigating officer in the case, pinned Onebe to his wife's murder.
I established a hedge of protection around my marriage because it is a sin. It's in the confession of Matthew 18:18, which in open quotation, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven.
Okello indicated that during their investigations, they discovered the deceased diary in which they learnt that the deceased had misunderstandings with her husband for several years.
A person brought people to remove the medicine from the storing house, which moves even to our small house, in the witch was there. The accident that I had was because of that.
In the diary, the deceased had indicated that because of their marital woes, her life was at stake.
Watch TV, food, tea, stuff, and eat. To watch TV, to bed, she even asked the guard to come and get tea for me, who are mine.
Okello went ahead and revealed that a second book recovered from the deceased's bedroom also indicated that in 2020, Onebe and some of his older children had ganged up and accused her of witchcraft. This created a huge rift between the couple until Asio's death.
The uncle also had a meeting as regards this same issue.
The investigating officers also indicated that even after Onebe reported his wife's alleged abduction, he refused to hand over her phones to the security personnel who were investigating the abduction, an indication that he was hiding something. The witnesses showed court some phones later recovered from Onebe. Onebe is jointly charged with one, Bonnie Oriekot, who was a security guard attached to the Pentagon Security Company owned by Onebe and his late wife. The two entered a plea of not guilty before the head of the High Court's Criminal Division, Justice Michael Elubu. Meanwhile, the High Court in Kampala has ruled that the dismissal of Asha Wilson Owere as the Chairman General of the National Organization of Trade Unions was illegal.
They can quote a Gambia, they are breaking the laws. Who are these people breaking the laws in the names of workers?
Owere was dismissed from his office in November 2022 by a group led by the NUTO Secretary General Peter Werike and Deputy Chairman General Stephen Mogole, who chaired a General Council meeting in Kampala. They accused him of dictatorship, failure to conduct meetings and abusing his powers, among others. At the same meeting, Werike, also Bubolo West Member of Parliament, stepped down willingly following concerns from members including Owere that it was wrong for one to be Secretary General while also serving as Member of Parliament. Owere sought a judicial review of the process in the High Court, calling for a declaration that it was illegal and violated the Labour Unions Act and the NUTO Constitution.
To see workers happy, have a better job security, better salary, good working environment.
Justice Musa Sekana declared that Tom Amiti, the acting Secretary General, had no mandate to call a council meeting and that all the outcomes of the said meeting were null and void. Owere was overjoyed by the court's decision.
This victory is for the workers of Uganda. And my appeal to the workers of Uganda, that let them guard this victory jealously.
Report compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.